Oh, no. That's how rough. Dana, come on in. Have a seat.
Hi there. Nice to meet you. I'm Dr. Schneider.
Thanks for taking the time out to meet with us. Whole staff here is really excited to get to know you. A couple of questions just to get acquainted with one another. What would you say is one of your greatest strengths?
So, Dana, what was going on with that patient?
So it was a lady who had a pituitary adenoma. Neurosurgery took it out today, and then whenever she woke up, she had some visual field complaints. So I talked to Drucker, and then I went and saw her. The exam was pretty much normal, except she did have some weird stuff on the confrontational fields. So then I talked to Drucker, and you know, he basically said it's okay, we can just have her follow up in clinic in like 5 or 6 weeks.
Oh, you ran it by Drucker though?
Yeah. So then I called him back again after that, and he said, yeah, 5 or 6 weeks is fine, Dana. So we're just going to have her follow up for an actual visual fields test in clinic, but there's nothing else to do. So I'm actually signing the note right now.
You get another one?
Yeah, let me check. Let's see. New consult. That's weird. I just signed that one. Hang on. Let me return this real quick. All right. It's kind of weird. Why is this up here again?
Hey, this is neurology.
Hey, this is Dana Schneider with ophthalmology. I'm returning a page.
Hey, Dr. Schneider. Good to hear from you. There's a patient we've got here, known to service, has a pituitary adenoma that was just affected. And,
okay.
You've got to come and take another look because she's got some visual field deficits and we want you to do some automated perimetry.
Well, did you read the note that I just signed this note. We went and did visual fields.
Yeah, but you know, we really think that this would be beneficial for the patient.
But I already did the fields. I don't understand what you're saying.
Well, like, they can count our fingers too. You know, we just want you to do like something. I'll do something a little more in depth.
Like, you want me to bring a $100,000 machine into TGH? That weighs hundreds of pounds, and then just on my back and bring it in and come see the patient with it? I mean, I got fingers too. I mean, you have fingers, I have fingers. The patient's gonna 5 weeks in clinic. I don't know what you want from me. This is a complete consult. I literally just saw this patient 5 minutes ago. I don't understand what you want.
So when are you gonna see the patient?
You know, I think my interpersonal skills are really my best strength, I would say.
Oh, that's great, that's great. Same vein, what's your greatest weakness?
Are you sure you don't want a sandwich? I got enough for both of us.
No, it's fine, Dana. It's
okay.
Fine.
So what do you think about that patient that we saw earlier?
I don't know. I mean, I see what you're saying. It definitely could be that really complicated diagnosis, but I don't know. It might just be conjunctivitis.
Yeah, I don't know, though. The eye was a little redder than I would think with conjunctivitis.
Yeah. Well, I mean, what did Drucker have to say?
So I called Drucker about it, and he was, you know, wondering why I was calling him at 3 a.m.
Yeah.
But, you know, then we talked about it for a while.
Yeah.
I don't know. He said it was conjunctivitis, but he seemed pretty sleepy. So
yeah.
I don't know.
Dana, what's going on here?
You know, I'm lactose intolerant. I can't eat the cheese.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I mean, you can have it if you want.
No.
Yeah.
I think so.
I just gotta pick the cheese off of
it. Yeah. Okay.
Otherwise,
you do them all at the same time.
Yeah. I mean, I just, you know.
Sure.
I just got to eat this sandwich here.
Yeah.
But,
okay. I'm sorry, I interrupted you though. Drucker.
Yeah, I don't know. So I talked to Drucker about it, and, you know, I was trying to get out of seeing that other consult that they talked to me about. But,
yeah.
You know, they didn't really bite.
Yeah.
So, whenever I was talking to him later on, he was saying, you know, you got to see the patient, it's an open globe, whatever.
Sure.
But, I mean, they came in like that.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's nothing we did. So, I mean, I don't know. It's just kind of complicated sometimes.
Yeah, I could have sworn. Didn't you tell me you couldn't eat cheese?
I just can't help myself sometimes, you know.
Oh, okay.
Cheese.
Huh.
Thank you.
guys. Goodness.
Thank you.
Wow, yeah, no problem. Wow. Well, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Quite the surprise, I guess. You know, you don't put that on the CV. That's fine, though. That's fine. We're happy to get to know you. How far along are you?
Pardon? I don't follow, sir.
Okay, that's fine. We'll just keep things moving. So tell us, what are some of your great strengths?
Oh, man, Whitney, we got another console.
Let's go.
Do you need some help?
I've got it. Sorry, I've got it. Let's get the gear. Let's go.
Grab all your stuff. Nice and easy, Whitney. Let's go see some consoles. Are you sure you want to take the stairs?
You know I don't take the elevator, Sahas.
What floor did you say we're going to?
9A.
9A? You said you said 2!
Almost there, Sahas. This is what first year's all about. Teamwork.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. We love teamwork here. And what would you say is one of your weaknesses?
Careful, careful. We're sterile here.
Is everything okay out there?
Look at the light, sir.
I don't know. Okay. Yeah, I mean, may have caught you off guard with that one. That's not something you always hear or at an interview. That's okay. That's fine.
Come on in. How are you? We're super excited to meet you.
Another day.
Yeah, very observant, Chris. So, tell me what one of your biggest strengths is.
So, what's going on with us?
Yeah, so this guy's got to go to the OR. The day team was super sweet, though, and they actually prepped all the documents for us.
So, you didn't write this?
No, it was the day team.
Can't trust anyone. Only thing I trust? This is where I find my strength.
Okay. Some people find it in themselves, others in a book. Good to know.
The only book.
And what about your biggest weakness, Chris?
Yeah, I don't... Hey, Keith.
I just wanted to run things by you real quick.
Okay.
So I got a 43-year-old guy. He's got like no real past medical or ocular history. He does wear contacts and he's been sleeping in them.
Okay. Wait. Just. Okay. You can stop right there. Whatever's wrong with him? Did you read wills?
I mean, it seems pretty straightforward. I just wanted to run it by you.
But did you read wills? Is it straightforward because you read wills? Are you familiar with wills?
I mean,
Cheryl, where's my copy of wills? Are you familiar with wills?
Yeah, I mean, I've heard of it, but I didn't think I would need to.
Okay, Keith, hang on there. Do you know where I'm getting ready to head to?
I don't know. Was it
Philadelphia?
It's like something up north somewhere, I thought.
Keith, if you haven't read wills. I don't really understand why we're on the phone right now.
Okay, well...
All right, okay, so just, if you still don't get it after Will's, then you can call me back, all right? That sounds good.
Okay.
I think you're only as weak as your weakest link. For me, it's my first years. Gonzalo?
Call me G.
Okay, yeah, sure. Yep, take a seat, that's fine. G, very nice to meet you. We're all really excited to get to know you here.
How you doing, man?
Don, doing just fine. How are you?
Doing awesome.
That's great. That's really great. That's great. Confident.
That's what they say.
Who?
Everyone.
Wow, okay, all right. Well, you know, I'd like to get to know you a little bit better. Mm-hmm. What would you say is one of your greatest strengths, G?
Hello?
Hey, Gonzalo, it's Keith. I just got a quick question. I wanted to run a patient by you.
Okay.
I'm seeing here at DGH.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
He's a 33-year-old guy. He's an IV drug user.
Mm-hmm.
He's coming in. He's had like mm-hmm. 5 or 6 days of just a really painful red eye, a lot of blurry vision. The vision's been getting worse this whole time.
Mm.
I took a look. It's really hard to see through the cornea. It just like looks a little... pretty hazy. Yeah. The anterior chamber is kind of like a lot of cell in it, so it's kind of hard to see through as well. I B scanned it, and mm-hmm. there's like a lot of vitritis. There's just a bunch of like dense opacities in the vitreous when I was looking at it.
So really just, could just be a PVD. Uh-huh.
Okay. What about all the cell in the anterior chamber?
Yeah. Sounds like a corneal ulcer, some vitine possibly, PVD, subconjunctive. I'm sure he has some trauma they didn't tell you about.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, I would just culture what you can culture and have them follow up tomorrow.
Okay. There's not like an epithelial defect or anything. What should I be culturing?
You can culture it. I know you can. Mm-hmm.
Just culture all over the surface of the cornea or what?
Just culture the cornea and have them follow up. Yeah.
Okay. Follow up in the ER, or he doesn't have insurance.
Just tell him to follow up at Marsani.
Okay. All right, sounds good. Thanks, Gonzalo.
Oh, man. These kids. Definitely being cool under pressure.
Yeah, I could sense that.
Yeah.
And what would you say is one of your weaknesses?
Hey, Gonzalo, you remember that patient we saw earlier? We were concerned they were open, so they're admitted, maybe going to the OR later.
It rings a bell, I think, yeah. What's up?
Well, medicine called, and I guess they're concerned something about the moxie that we recommended, and the QTC is kind of long, so they wanted to know if there were any alternatives. I mean, he's got a significant heart history with the QTC and all.
How important do you think a QTC is? I mean, moxifloxacin is very important.
Yeah, I don't know how these medicine docs get with the QTC and all.
Oh, my tummy hurts.
Yeah, no, you've been saying that.
You know, sometimes my tummy just gives me problems.
Oh, that's unfortunate.